So today, we are going to talk about one of the three main causes of dysgraphia, or poor handwriting, visual misperceptions. We'll talk about why cursive works better for these kids, and finally, I'll show you the dramatic effects that improving a child's visual perception can have on handwriting with a real-life example from one of my own students. In my experience, there are three common causes of dysgraphia, or poor handwriting: processing problems, motor problems, or visual perception problems. It is this last cause that I am going to focus on in this video today. So the first question that some people might ask is, what is a visual perception problem? Does it mean the child has vision deficiencies? That they're nearsighted or farsighted? No, not at all. In fact, usually the child's vision will be normal. It has to do with the brain's ability to interpret what information the eyes are taking in. These kids tend to be dominant in the right brain. And I've talked a lot about the visual kinesthetic child in previous videos. Today, I'd like to talk mostly about the VKA student. So if you haven't watched the previous videos on how kids learn through their senses, please do that. And then you'll understand what these symbols, VKA, stand for. Now this VKA learner, they don't see any need to leave things where they're at. For the child who spins things, life is confusing. Whenever they go to read, they have to try to figure out what direction letters are supposed to be in. When they go to write, they have a very hard time. Each letter is a challenge for them visually. So they want to find, you know, they want to write a letter A or whatever. They're like, whoa, where is it? And the spatialness, the lines of the paper might even be moving. And they're like, oh, I gotta find that line. Oh, okay, I got it. All right, now I got another letter. Okay. You know, and they're just having a heck of a time trying to find those letters. In fact, that's one reason why visual-spatial kids actually do better with cursive, because they only have to find that line once, and once they find it, they get to stay there. They don't have to keep moving or, you know, keep finding the line again. And they also don't perceive the sizing of their letter correctly. So, you know, you have the child who makes a large letter and then a small letter, and, you know, and their spacing is very odd and that sort of thing, because their perception, their visual perception is off. A most dramatic story of that was with a student. She was about 10 years old. She came into tutoring with me in May of the year she started with me, quite near the beginning. We were doing some writing, and this is what her handwriting looked like. Now, 2 months later, I never ever worked on handwriting with her. I only worked on her visual perception. And 2 months later, I'll show you as she... This is what her handwriting looked like when she started with me. And here's how it progressed over the next 2 months as I helped her tone down her visual confusions. See how it's getting smaller and smaller, neater and neater. Until 2 months later, this is what her handwriting looks like. I did not do any handwriting work with her, not at all. The only thing I did with her was help her to learn how to perceive, visually perceive things correctly. Help her mind to interpret what she was seeing correctly. The hope for all this is there are exercises that we can do to help the child overcome this disability. We can tone down that visual
spatial misperception that they have. And then they come into the normal range and they're able to succeed much more readily in their academics. Now, if you're wondering if your child is a visual-spatial learner, your child personally or your student, there's a few things you can look for in another video. So I just really want to share all this wealth of information I've learned over the years. And if you like what you're seeing, please hit that like button.
And if you're interested in learning more about the causes of dysgraphia, click on that video right there on the screen. Or if you'd like to know if your child has visual perception problems, there's another great video for you to watch. Have a great week, and I'll see you in the next one.